Welcome to the video number 8 on electronics communication. In this video, we discuss about the complete frequency modulation. The contents in that are modulation index, the percentage modulation, frequency spectrum, and bandwidth, frequency deviation and carrier swing, deviation ratio, FM transmitter, comparison of FM and IM, and also the advantages. All these topics are discussed now. First of all, let's see what is the frequency modulation. When the frequency of the carrier wave is changed in accordance with the intensity of the input signal, and that is called the frequency modulation. Here, let's look into this in detail, how that changes. You know that the frequency is the number of oscillations per second. This is the frequency of the carrier wave, which will be normally in megahertz. That means the frequency of this carrier signal is little bit higher than the audio signal. Now let me take one oscillate sound signal. It is the audio signal. So according to this is the carrier wave, and whose frequency will change according to this amplitude of the audio signal. At this point A, now the frequency remains same as that of the carrier wave. Original frequency will be there. When the amplitude of the audio signal is increased, and its frequency increases, carrier frequency increases. So you can see the compressions at these points. That means number of oscillations per second increased. Once again, when it comes to the normal position, so here the carrier wave will have its normal frequency. So when the audio signal comes to the negative position, are in the opposite direction, here the oscillations would expand, or we see the rarefied region. Once again, this goes to normal position, and this carrier wave has its normal frequency. When it goes to the higher amplitude, here frequency is more. Like this, the frequency modulation occurs in accordance with the audio signal. You can see here how the carrier wave has been changed. So this is the region where the crest was there. That means higher amplitude, more frequency seen. Here 130 kilohertz. This is the normal frequency of the carrier wave, and once again at the rarefied region, the frequency decreases to 70 kilohertz. Once again it goes to normal position, 100 kilohertz. So here we can observe that 100 kilohertz, 100 kilohertz, and 100 kilohertz. So these are the normal regions where its frequency is 100 kilohertz. So this frequency is called the central frequency, or central frequency, or the carrier frequency. And where we can see the higher frequency, and this is the frequency increased region, and this is the frequency decreased region, and this is called the frequency deviation. So deviation is for about here 30 kilohertz, and here also 30 kilohertz. So this is in the upper region, this is in the lower region. We can see further in detail into that one. So here we have the amplified region, here the oscillations are compressed. You see the negative amplitude of the audio signal, You see the expansion of oscillations. So this is changing according with the input signal. Now the amplitude of the audio signal is still increased, and you can see the still compressed oscillations. When it is in the negative direction, you can see the expansion of the frequency region. So from this what you can see is there is the frequency of the carrier signal is directly proportional to the amplitude of the input signal. So what are the points we have to bear in mind? The frequency deviation of the FM signal depends on the amplitude of the modulating signal, and the central frequency won't change without modulating signal. The audio frequency does not determine the frequency deviation. Now let's discuss the theory of FM. The modulating sine wave has Em is equal to m cos omega t. Here Em is the amplitude of the modulating signal and it is its frequency. Let the carrier wave has changed its frequency to k times the modulating signal, where k is the frequency deviation constant. The instantaneous frequency of the carrier is given by frequency. Instantaneous frequency is equal to the frequency of the carrier signal plus frequency deviation. Now this f is equal to fc plus, we know this constant k, and em is em cos omega m into t. So this is taken from the this is the modulating signal. Now we know that the carrier frequency is varying from fc plus kem to fc minus kem. So this is the frequency oscillations. That means the carrier frequency is swinging between these two regions. So this swinging is taken as change in frequency. And that can be written as delta f. So here k into m is k plus k into m, here minus km. So this region is taken as delta f. On substituting the k em is equal to delta f, we get this equation. Here this is the instantaneous frequency. Now the instantaneous angular frequency of the fm is omega is equal to omega c plus delta omega c into cos omega m into t. We have written the same frequency in the angular frequency form. Now the total phase angle is theta is equal to omega t. When you integrate this one, omega into t, integral from 0 to t. Now we have to substitute the expression for omega in this equation and then integrate. We will get theta is equal to omega into t plus delta omega c into cos omega m t. Integration is sine omega m by omega m. We get E is equal to EC into cos omega c t plus mf sine omega m t. So this is the general voltage equation for FM wave. Now we see the modulation index. This is here fc max minus fc can be written as delta f, and fm is written as it is. And the modulation index mf can be greater than 1 in this FM. If you see the frequency spectrum, when the FM carrier signal is modulated, infinite number of side bands are formed on both sides of center frequency at equal distances, and then the bandwidth is given by 2 into n into fm. Here you can see this is the frequency spectrum, this is the central frequency, and it is f naught plus fm, f naught plus 2 fm. Like this, the bands, infinite number of bands are formed on the right side, and this side also infinite number of bands are formed. Another expression for the bandwidth is 2 into delta f plus fm. So if the modulation is index is more than 6, then we can use this formula to calculate the bandwidth. Two important points are to be noted. The center frequency is represented by f0 or fc. The carrier swing is given by 2 into delta f, that is 2 into frequency deviation. The maximum deviation of 75 kHz is allowed for the FM. Now we see the modulation index. So the modulation index is the ratio of the frequency deviation to the modulating frequency. Now the deviation ratio is the frequency deviation to the maximum permitted audio frequency, that is delta f by f max m. For FM broadcast stations, f max is 75 kHz, and the maximum permitted frequency for modulating audio signal is 15 kHz, and the deviation ratio can be calculated. So here the delta f is given, frequency deviation is 75 kHz, and the maximum audio frequency is 15 kHz, so which is deviation ratio is 5. The percent modulation is equal to the ratio of actual frequency deviation to the maximum allowed frequency deviation, that is delta f actual to the delta f max. Now let's see the FM transmitter. The FM transmitter is a low power FM radio transmitter which allows listening to the music. The block diagram of FM transmitter consists of the crystal oscillator, narrow band PM, and then integrator, frequency multiplier 1, mixer, crystal oscillator 2, and frequency multiplier 2, and then RF amplifier. First, the crystal oscillator generates the carrier signal at low frequency for about 1 MHz, and this is applied to the combining network and 90 degree phase shifter. The audio signal or modulating signal is passed through an audio equalizer to boost the low modulating frequencies, which is generally an integrator. This modulating signal is then applied to a balanced modulator. This modulating signal is then applied to a balanced modulator. The balanced modulator produces two side bands such that their resultant is 90 degree phase shifted with the unmodulated carrier. The unmodulated carrier and the 90 degree phase shifter are then added to the combining network. At the output of the combining network, we get the FM signal, and this FM signal has low carrier frequency and modulation index, and this will be raised by the first group of multipliers. And then the frequency of the carrier is then raised by the crystal oscillator 2, and then FC, that is the carrier frequency, and also the modulation index, both are raised by the mixer. And then it is rise to further required level by using the frequency multiplier 2. So here we can rise both FC and MF to our required values by using the second group of multipliers, and then this signal is further applied to the class C RF amplifier to rise the power level of FM signal, and then it is sent to the transmitting signal. Let's see the comparison between the FM and AM. In the FM, the sideband amplitudes are 0 at modulation 86. The sideband amplitudes is never 0 for any value of modulation index. In the AM, it has noise immunity, but AM has no noise immunity, no interference of signals in the FM. In the AM, interference occur. Bandwidth is about 20 kHz in the FM. In the AM, it is 100 Hz. FM circuits are very complex. AM circuits are simple and cheap. In the FM, modulation index may be greater than or less than 1. But in the AM, it should be always between 0 and 1. Here, the transmitter power independent of the modulation index. But here, the transmitted power depends on the modulation index. Modulation index determines the number of significant pairs of sidebands. Here, only two sidebands are produced. The amplitude of the FM wave is constant in this one, and hence the transmitted power is constant. FM is more immune to the noise than the AM reception. That means it won't allow any noise, no interference of signal with the FM. These are the advantages. In addition to that, it gives noiseless reception, and then the operating range is quite large in this one, and it gives high fidelity, no interference of channels. The efficiency of the transmission is very high. Disadvantages: much larger bandwidth is required for this FM, and service area of the FM is more. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe below for more notifications and videos.